Hey, it's Thomas here, and today we're doing a quick review on Brightwell Aquatics Export Bio Brick and Microbacter 7 combination. If you're going to be setting up a bare bottom tank, planning a minimalist aquascape, or just want to make sure that you have all of the biological filtration you'll need regardless of what's in your display, using cutting edge biological media with incredible surface area, seeded with a blend of aerobic and anaerobic bacteria, as well as enzymes to help get your tank cycled quickly while subduing the notorious ugly phase, then Brightwell's Export Bio Brick and Microbacter 7 are the dream team you're looking for. Whew, the surface area. When it comes to filtration to maintain overall tank health, biological media does the heavy lifting. The microbes in your tank, aka bacteria, spend all of their time converting harmful substances like ammonia to much less harmful ones like nitrate, preventing them from reaching toxic levels, which keeps your tank hospitable for your fish, corals, inverts, and other inhabitants. These beneficial nitrifying and denitrifying bacteria like to live on surfaces and need a place to call home. There are lots of different ways to provide them with the real estate that they need to populate and reach sufficient numbers to handle the bioload of your inhabitants. The rock and substrate in your tank provides lots of surface area for bacteria to grow on, but if you have a bare bottom system, minimalist rock work, or plan to stock heavily, you might need to add some extra living space for those microbes if you want them to be able to keep up and make sure your tank stays ammonia free, and you know, just generally has lower nutrients so that things like algae don't take over and ruin the day. Brightwell's Export Bio Brick and Microbacter 7 are an awesome combo for adding an astonishing amount of surface area for biological filtration and instantly providing the necessary aerobic and anaerobic bacteria as well as enzymes to get your tank cycled and gracefully through the ugly stage as quickly and painlessly as possible. Especially for bare bottom tanks, as Ryan and Randy have shown, they can be a lot tougher and take a lot longer to completely cycle and, you know, stabilize, get through that ugly phase. This is definitely gonna help. In the box, you'll find the Export Bio Brick rated for up to 1,000 gallons of aquarium water and Microbacter 7. Now, Brightwell's Export Bio Media Brick might look similar to some other media bricks and plates, but it's actually unique in a number of ways. Firstly, it has, hands down, the most surface area I have ever seen in a biomedia with an astonishing 71,000 square feet of surface area per liter of media, putting that Export Bio Brick at a crazy 100,000 square feet of surface area. And yes, it has been thoroughly lab tested and those numbers are sound. I had to check too. Water flows through the media easily, which is important since it means that nutrients and oxygen can make it through the entire pore network of the brick, making all of the surface area usable for nitrifying bacteria. The spheres on the bottom of the brick allow for water to pass easily underneath it, preventing detritus buildup and allowing for ideal flow on all sides, whether it's resting on the bottom of the sump or stacked on top of another brick. Export Bio is also unique as it contains aragonite to buffer the pH inside of the media to prevent acids from building up and inhibiting the bacteria, meaning more useful, usable surface area for productive bacterial processes. Which basically just means the bacteria can use the entire brick really efficiently. None of it's wasted. Brightwell is able to pull this off by using a unique process to create their ultra porous media that allows them to avoid the super high temperatures that competing medias need to cure their product during the manufacturing process and makes for a harder, lighter, and more porous material. It is actually so effective that Brightwell openly states not to use more than one single brick per 100 gallons of aquarium water and to divide the brick or use the Export Bio cubes for smaller tanks. This is definitely a more does not equal better scenario. Adding more than you need of Export Bio really won't yield any benefit. And I can really appreciate that a company is stepping up and telling you not to buy more of their product, especially when it comes to something like biomedia, where traditionally more is better has been, you know, the way to go. And I'm just saying, I appreciate it. As awesome as the Export Bio Brick is, it is only a blank slate for bacteria, and that is where Microbacter 7 comes in. It is a proprietary blend of aerobic and anaerobic bacteria and enzymes designed not only to jumpstart your biological filtration and help cycle your aquarium quickly with a variety of nitrifying bacteria, but also to minimize the ugly stage of starting a new reef tank with a blend of microbes and enzymes that will reduce unwanted nutrients in the system that pest algae and bacteria would otherwise be using to grow and spread and, well, make the tank look awful for a while, which nobody wants. The faster we can go from starting the tank and cycling to it being ready for corals with as little algae and grime in between, the better. To seed your Export Bio Brick, first rinse it thoroughly with RODI or purified water to remove any dusty fines, and then place it in a container big enough to hold the brick and allow it to be covered completely in water. Next, add aquarium water until the brick is completely submersed. Then shake up your bottle of Microbacter 7 to make sure all of the substrate-bound bacteria are suspended. Next, add the whole 250 milliliter bottle over top of the brick and let it sit for 24 hours. Then add the brick, water and all, to your sump. By the end of that 24-hour period, all of the bacteria will have come out of their state of suspended animation, adhered themselves to the brick, and are ready to start converting harmful ammonia and breaking down other unwanted nutrients. Whether you're going to go bare bottom or choosing to use substrate in your display, not having to worry as much about where your bacteria are going to call home and how to get enough bacteria in your system is hugely helpful, but definitely not all you want to consider. Ryan and Randy break down all of the different things you'll want to think about when choosing sand or no sand in this video right here. This is actually one of my favorite lives that I've seen so far. It's really good. And if you missed it, you'll find out why Ryan chose to go with sand or no sand